The things that we left behind in Atlantis, they are coming back to us in one form or another. We've gone through a lot of, I guess, peregrinations would be the word, and we'll continue to do so. The political structure that we have now doesn't even start to compare to what we had in Atlantis. In Atlantis, I didn't see the crime and the corruption and the greed. I didn't see that. Now, maybe it was there, but I didn't see it. Now, one of the things that was really jolting to me was that I could hear music in the background.
I'd like to welcome back to the show returning champion, Connie Deutsch. How are you doing, Connie?
I'm fine. How about you?
I am doing great, Connie. I'm doing so great. It is such a pleasure having you back on the show. It's been a while since you've been on the show. And for people who don't know who you are, I'm going to give them a little brief introduction to who you are, because you're a very, very important person in my life. And the last time you were on, we've hit over almost a million views across all languages with you. I know, right? So many people really, really love you and what you say, how you say it, and they enjoy our banter, because there's nobody else on the planet who talks to me like you do, and I can talk back. So for everybody who's watching, Connie is my, for lack of a better word, spiritual guide, who's been with me since I was 23. She has been trying to guide me patiently all those years to where you see us today. She is responsible for the creation of this show, meaning that she is the one that told me I had to do it. I did all the heavy lifting, but she pointed me in the direction, and with a very firm hand pointed me in the direction that you have to start a spiritual podcast. When I said it was insane, she said, "You got 3 weeks." So if you've enjoyed Next Level Soul, this woman in front of you that you're watching is pretty much the main reason this is in existence. Without her, it would have never occurred to me to open up a spiritual podcast. So that's who you are.
And you said only 3 weeks.
Yes, that's crazy. No one could do that.
And I said, "You're right. No one could do that, but you can." And you did.
And I did. I did.
You did everything in 3 weeks.
Website, new logo, trademarked the logo, had guests, had a podcast, audio editing, video, started a YouTube channel, all of it within 3 weeks, because we needed to launch on Easter of 2021 is when we launched.
Easter Sunday,
2021 is when we launched this. You were like, that's a good time to launch this show. That's going to be a good time.
No, that's not what I said.
What did you say? You see, here we go.
I said, the channel said you have to start it on Easter Sunday.
That's right.
And I don't make the mistake of arguing with the channel anymore.
Correct. And that's the other thing I forgot to tell people, that you are a channel. You have been channeling for years, but you're not a trans all your life, but you're not a trans channel. You actually just, you ask questions and it comes through, or sometimes the channel just does what it wants to do and kind of sends you information whether you like it or not.
That's all the time.
Exactly.
Not just sometimes. It's all the time. I don't have my say in the channel.
So you have been such an instrumental part of my life, and an extension, been an instrumental part of everyone watching's lives, because without you, this show wouldn't have existed. So you've been on the show now 4 times. The first 2 times were audio only, which I'm going to re-release in the future, because they were very powerful conversations. But the first video one we did was the last one, which was a little bit, I think a year ago or a little less than a year ago, that came out. And like I said before, people went a little crazy for you, because we talked about your visions in Atlantis, talked about our relationship together, and your life was kind of turned upside down after the airing of the show, correct?
Has it ever? Yes.
You were booked up. You were booked up for how many months? I mean, months and months. We turned it off. I think you turned it off because you're like, I can't anymore.
Well, wait a moment.
Yeah.
You might have turned it off.
Mm-hmm.
But do you know what I've been getting?
What?
Oh, I was just at my friend's house and we were listening to Alex and you. And that's why I'm calling.
Mm-hmm.
So it has legs of its own.
Oh God. And it's and now, and you also have now people in Spanish calling you, and in German and in French.
Habla español? No. No hablo. Un poquito.
Un poquito. Un poquito solo.
Solamente.
Solamente. Solamente un poquito. Very uh-huh. good. You're getting better. You're getting better. So the reason why I brought you back on the show is that you called me and said, Alex, I think it's time for me to come back on the show. And I have a lot of stuff to tell you. And I'm going to wait till the show. So unlike any other episode I have ever done in the history of this show, I have no notes. I have no idea what we're talking about at all. And we're
right.
the audience is going to go on the ride with me and you to go wherever you are going to take us. But you said it was going to be pretty mind-blowing. So I'm going to build it up here. It's going to be pretty mind-blowing. You were really curious on how I was going to react to it. And I'm open to whatever you have to say because I know you're nuts already. And that's clear. That's been clear since I was 20 something. So I'm very well aware of that. So I'm really curious. So I will hand this over to you now, Connie. Tell me what was so important that you wanted to come back on the show to talk to me about it and to share it with the world.
Okay. Let me establish one thing.
Yes.
That I am reality based. I'm not one of these woo-woo people. I'm not one of these people who is airy fairy.
That's true.
I'm very grounded.
Mm-hmm.
And what you're about to hear and to see will defy everything you ever thought about me. About, I guess it was a couple of weeks ago.
Mm-hmm.
A couple of weeks ago, I had a very unusual experience, tremendously so. And I want to establish the fact that I'm not one of these woo-woo people. I started a couple of fictional books that I never got around to finishing, and that was a few years ago. Because I don't have that kind of a creative imagination. I'm not like Alex. Alex can make a whole story out of a thin thread. I can't. It has to be reality based. So my 13 books that I have published all are reality based. These two books are not. They're fiction. And I can't finish them because I don't know what to do with them.
Mm-hmm.
Now, what you're going to hear defies all of that. If I didn't tell you about this, you'd probably have me locked up in a loony bin.
Mm-hmm.
I was sitting here. My mind was vacant. I was not preparing to meditate. I was just sitting here. And all of a sudden, I could feel my body being picked up, and then whoosh, and I wasn't here anymore. I landed in Atlantis. Not just landed in Atlantis, but this was right before it sank, right before the floods. So that's where we're going to take. I recognize all the people from Atlantis. My name was Artica, and everything that you're about to hear sounds like Looney Tunes.
Mm-hmm.
It took me 3 days just to process it before I could even talk about it.
Okay.
I know the difference between a picture, a video, and a real life experience. This was a real life experience. I was actually in Atlantis.
Okay.
I could hear everything. I could feel everything. And of course, I recognized you, Alex.
Mm-hmm.
I recognize all the people who have come to me for consultations over the past few months. I recognized everyone. Now, the things that I was hearing were astronomical. This was before Atlantis sank into the ocean, and they were just about getting prepared. They were just hearing that Atlantis was in danger. Nobody knew what it was. I was a high priestess in that incarnation. So these are my pupils who had gone through the training with me. And the trainings are very energetic, to say the very least. You learn how to create miracles on a daily basis. Nothing is impossible. Everything is doable. And there is no such thing as can't do, because everything can be done. And I was training these people to do it. So now I have this whole room full of people, all of whom I've recognized from the consultations that I've done in the 9 months since we had that first video cast.
Mm-hmm.
And it suddenly dawned on me that I need to prepare my students. And this is what happened. I started talking about, as I said, I've just received a message. And I didn't tell them it was channeled. I didn't have to. I said, I just received a message that we have to leave Atlantis now, today. You are not allowed to take anything with you except for one item. And that item has to be very lightweight. So it can be a book. It can be a scarf. It can be anything that's lightweight. You are not allowed to take anybody with you. So if you have family and friends, they're going to be left behind because they're not going to be allowed to come. So that means if they are caught with someone else, or if they're caught with two things that they want to take, they're going to be left in Atlantis. Hmm. And that means that they are going to die. So that's your decision. But we have to leave now. The reason I have all of you here is because I have trained all of you. So each and every one of you has been chosen, so to speak. And the reason that you've been chosen is for a number of reasons. Number one, you've been very well trained. Number two, which is very important to me, is that each of you has wisdom. Each of you can think your way out of a paper bag. Now, you may not know what a paper bag is. This is Atlantis. So you may not know what a paper bag is. But in the future, many millions of years into the future, you will know what a paper bag is. Right now, just know that you are a chosen one because you have all the things that are needed to survive. Each of you is going to be placed in a different part of the world. You will be different colors. You'll be different beliefs, and each of you will be the beginning of a new civilization in the different parts of the world. So right now, I'm looking at all of you, and you look confused, and I don't blame you, because it's kind of confusing to me as well, because I just got the message moments before you walked into the room. Right now, the things that are of most concern is going to be survival. the people you're leaving behind will no longer exist after today. So you won't be able to say goodbye. You won't be able to do any last minute things. You have enough time to grab one item that's lightweight and be ready to go. I will tell you each where your destination is, because they're not going to be together. So the people that you see in this room, they're not going to be with you. None of them. Nor will I. We're all in this together, but we're apart, so to speak. So now, if any of you have any questions, this is the time to ask them, because you won't have a chance later on. Atlantis will no longer exist. I'm from your future, and you don't know that yet, because you're millions of years from my past. Someday, you will know it, but that isn't for a very long time. Now, each of you has been trained up to the eyebrows. You can do anything that you have in your mind. All you have to do, as you know from past experience, all you have to do is think it, and it happens. And that is called mind transference. When you get to where you're going, make sure that you do not use your voice, because that will identify you. And that's something you don't want right now. Because right now we don't know who our enemies are, or if we have enemies. Someday we may find out, but it probably won't be in this lifetime. You're all destined to future lives. It may be difficult for you to believe now, but someday you will see that you have lived many, many lifetimes. So starting now, take a look around. Put it in your mind, in your memory, because you're going to have to draw on it in the future. Someday, you're going to have to figure out a way for survival that is very different from the way you're surviving today. Someday, people won't remember Atlantis, or someday they may have heard of it, but there's nothing to ground them, so there's nothing that they can hold on to. And that's where you come in. Your job would be to tell them, to bring this message to them. There are going to be many, many Earth changes and many changes in the galaxy. You probably don't know about Earth yet, and you probably don't know about the galaxy yet, but you will. So keep your mind open. You will be asked to do things that are unfamiliar to you. And when you have to do them, be open to learning, because your survival is going to depend on that. There's going to be a lot of wars that you know nothing about, a lot of instruments that you have yet to see, a lot of inventions that you have yet to hear of. So you need to keep an open mind. You can't close it, because that's going to be your survival. Alex, do you have any questions?
A couple. One is that you are essentially jumping into your lifetime, so almost quantum jumping into a parallel life or a quote-unquote past life that you had.
Yes.
And you are explaining to people who see you there, because you are, what kind of form are you? Are you of an Atlantean form, or are you
yes.
the form you see?
Oh, okay. Let me tell you that. In this lifetime, I am much, much younger. Even younger than I am now.
Uh-huh. Hard to believe, I understand.
Yeah, sure. in Atlantis to show that I was a high priestess. I wore a white gold band around my upper wrist, around my upper arm.
Okay.
In this lifetime, I've yet to wear anything like that. In this lifetime, I really don't wear jewelry except for one piece that's an heirloom from my mom before she died. Other than that, I don't. But in Atlantis, I did. And that was indicative of the fact that I was the high priestess who everyone came to for wisdom, for direction, for guidance, and to teach them, to train them, so that nothing is impossible. You think it, and you make it happen.
So when you were there, Connie, you saw me there as well?
Oh, yes.
Am I one of these people?
Yes.
Interesting.
Most definitely. Okay. You were one of the chosen ones then, and you're one of the chosen ones now.
Okay. So what happened next?
So then I took everyone and went to one area that was not really discovered. And I gave them all verbal directions where they were going and how they were going to get there. There were no animals to take because they were going to go elsewhere. That much was told to me. So it was going to be by foot. And we were not going to travel together. Each one was going to go separately. I don't know how that turned out, but I do know that we all went separately. And they were to different parts of the world. So nowadays, if you see people with yellow skin or black skin or white skin, you will know that they came from Atlantis, and this is where they were told to go. This was their destiny. And their destiny, and that includes you, Alex, their destiny was to bring forth the knowledge, the wisdom, and the tools that they will need to survive in this new environment. It was also told to me that what we know now will cease to exist in the not too distant future. What we know now will be like baby steps in comparison to what is coming for us. It reminds me very much of what I saw in Atlantis. So I will expect to see some destruction in this lifetime, in this century.
Hold on a second. I'm lost a little bit. So are we now away? We're now gone from Atlantis. Now you're just talking about what's happening now.
Yes.
Okay. Just wanted to clarify that. Okay. So start. Okay. So go ahead.
So the things that we left behind in Atlantis, they are coming back to us in one form or another. We've gone through a lot of, I guess, peregrinations would be the word, and we'll continue to do so. The political structure that we have now doesn't even start to compare to what we had in Atlantis. In Atlantis, I didn't see the crime and the corruption and the greed. I didn't see that. Now, maybe it was there, but I didn't see it. Now, one of the things that was really jolting to me was that I could hear music in the background. And the music signified what was going on. So the very somber music that I heard, that was in the foreground. And it was coming closer and closer and closer. And that meant that something terrible was going to happen. And I heard in the background, a very, very distant background, very joyful music. And that signified that the training had been successful and that the people who were trained had something to carry forth into their new lives. Some were going to survive, and in Atlantis, most of Atlantis went under the sea. In time to come, what was lost in Atlantis is going to surface. We're going to see bits and pieces of it rising from the sea in this lifetime. So it might be an island that will start to see bits and pieces come to the surface. It might be the continent itself. But the things that we did in Atlantis were so astounding. I saw a healing take place with the mind. All I had to do was say, I see someone on another continent who has a terminal illness and is in tremendous pain. Please, God, heal him or her completely, forever. And 2 minutes later, that healing was accomplished without the person even knowing that he or she was healed and never being sick again.
Why is that, by the way? How is that? How does that work? Is it direct? The level of consciousness is so high that there's a direct connection to source.
So high. Mm-hmm. We're coming into that. I can feel it every day of my life. I've been telling the people that you've been sending to me about it. It's coming. Right now, it's at war with the lower vibration that we've lived under all of our lives. And people will have a choice. Do you want to continue to live under this lower vibration that we've had all of our lives and you're accustomed to? Or do you want to train for the higher vibration, which will be a lot of work? And in addition to that, you will only be allowed on the higher vibration if you are working for the benefit of mankind. If you are greedy or selfish or corrupt, you will not be allowed on the higher vibration. On the higher vibration, I can stand on one side of the planet and think about someone on the other side of the planet, and that person will either appear or get well or something. But I will be able to communicate just by thinking it.
If you're enjoying this conversation, I invite you to go deeper down the rabbit hole with me on Next Level Soul TV. It's packed with exclusive content like live special guest Q&As, daily podcasts, commercial-free access to the entire Next Level Soul catalog, early access to episodes before they air, and special meditations you won't find anywhere else. We will be adding new exclusive content every month. Plus, you can connect with me during my monthly live streams. Just go to nextlevelsoul.com/subscribe and join our soulful community today. I'll see you on the inside. Let me ask you this, because
go ahead.
I've had conversations with people and gurus and channels and psychics who talk about this, that there is no past life or future life, that all lives are happening at the same time, that there is no time or space, and that life in Atlantis that you're talking about is happening right now, and our future life is happening right now, and they're all connected. And then what you're describing is quantum jumping, it seems to be, where you are able to kind of step out of this life, and wherever your attention goes, it follows to another life. So if we want to go to Egypt, we could go to Egypt if we want to go. And that's where a lot of these past life regressions go to, because they're not looking at past events. Those are events that are happening in the moment in that life. Does that make sense to you?
Well, I didn't finish telling you.
Okay, please continue. Continue then.
After everyone dispersed and went their own ways, mm-hmm. I was then physically transported to ancient Egypt. And there I was also a high priestess. And there were things that I understood, the hieroglyphics that were on the walls. I even contributed to some of them. We didn't have books. We didn't have any of the culture that we have today. But it was a lot easier to understand than it is now. I had something happen many, many years ago, probably about 20 years ago. I wanted to learn astrology, but I didn't really want to learn it. I just wanted to know about it. So I asked a woman who was an astrologer. I said, I'd do well when something's taught to me on a daily basis. Don't tell me about it once a week or once a month. I needed to see it every day. And it needs to be for a short time because I can absorb it in that short time. So she said, all right, if you will do a psychic reading for me every day, I will tutor you every day. And I'm thinking to myself, what the hell can I talk about on a daily basis? My life isn't going to change every day. So I agreed, and I had to dig very deep to try to think of something to tell her. One day, very shortly after we started, this was before computers, of course.
Of course.
Shut up.
You see the tone? You see what I've had to deal with for over 20-odd years now? This tone?
26 years.
26 years I've been dealing with this tone. Anyway, I didn't even mean anything by that. I was just saying, of course, there was no computer. Go ahead, continue. Good Lord. Continue.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay. So, because we didn't have computers, I had to learn how to do the computations by hand. Mm-hmm. It was all manual. And we got to something, and neither one of us could figure it out. So she went home, and I went, when I learned something, my way of learning is probably screwed up, but I put about 6 to 8 books on my bed, all spread out. And I go from one to the other, to the other, to the other, to the other. And I learn that way. And that's what I did that night. I had all my books spread out and nothing was covering it. And I was kind of disheartened. I went to sleep that night. And all of a sudden, I had a dream. And I was in Egypt. And on the left side were the hieroglyphs. And on the right side was everything in English. Well, the hieroglyphs were very easy to understand. And it was the equivalent of a paragraph. On the right side was all the English, and it was long and drawn out, and I didn't understand a word of it. The astrologer came the next day, and I took out the books, and I said to her, I know how to solve that problem that we were looking at yesterday. And I showed her how to do it. And it was algebra that I had learned in high school. Mm-hmm. Hadn't used it, hadn't thought about it, nothing. But the hieroglyphs were so easy to understand, and the English was so convoluted that I couldn't understand it. She got up, she said, when the student knows more than the teacher, it's time for me to leave. She picks up her stuff and walks out of the room, went home, and I never saw her again. When I was in Atlantis, I was wearing jewelry, like that gold band on my arm. In this life, with the exception of an heirloom piece left by my mom, mm-hmm. it's the only piece of jewelry I wear. Mm-hmm. I can admire it on other people, but I myself don't want to be bothered with it. And so I haven't. So I was dressed differently. Of course, I was much younger in Atlantis. And my hair was black. In this incarnation, it's brown. Clothing was different, but even to this day, in this incarnation, I'm not too conscious about clothing. It really doesn't occur. Yeah, you could wear the same thing every single day for the next 25 years and I won't know the difference.
Connie, what type of technology did you see when you were there?
I don't know what you would describe as technology. No, technology and I are not friends.
That's very true. But did you see anything that is so far beyond what we are doing right now that it's, it's something that you would want to talk about?
I don't know how to explain it.
Do the best you can with our convoluted English.
No, because it requires visualization, and I don't know how to describe it. Right now, some of the things that we have depended on mm-hmm. will be non-existent in a few years.
What is the, what, like what?
I don't know. I don't know the terms.
Okay. So some technologies that we have currently that we're extremely dependent on will be non-existent in a few years.
Yeah.
Very similar to, very similar to how, huh?
Like the computer. When I first started, there were no computers in existence, mm-hmm. at least none that I knew of. Mm-hmm. Well, it's going to be the same thing in 5 years, 10 years.
Well, yeah, it's similar to whale oil. That was the number one industry in the early 1900s. And then petroleum showed up and they were out of business in 3 years. It was gone. So they were doing whaling and getting the oil from the whales. And that's what used to run the lanterns. The second petroleum came into the world, it went away. So it can happen, and it can happen very quickly.
It's going to happen quickly. I remember when computers were just in its infancy. Mm-hmm. I made a prediction at that time that while everyone was thinking that it was going to be labor saving, it's not going to happen that way. But what's going to happen is that people will be out of jobs.
As any industry, any industry that gets upgraded or taken over by a new in technology, it's of course going to gain jobs and lose jobs, like AI is right now.
Yes, sweetheart, but you're talking about now. Mm-hmm. You're a baby.
I appreciate that.
In my generation, you didn't see what you're seeing today.
No, of course not.
So in my generation, things stayed around forever and ever. Today, you close your eyes and something new happens. And what was there is no longer there.
Well, listen, I mean, we were making movies for the same way for 110 years or so. We were shooting celluloid, exposing it to light, running it through a camera, and that's how we made movies. And things pretty much stayed the same, with a couple of things changing here and there. But now, that's almost all gone. And we make movies so differently, we can make a movie with a phone. It's completely changed. But it stood around for a long time, in our world at least, or at least in our timeline. So things do change, and things will continue to change. And they're changing so much faster than I've ever seen in my life.
Oh, you haven't seen anything yet.
It's going to really... So let me ask you, what do you think is going to happen moving forward? I mean, this is a weird year. This is an election year. You know, there's a lot of wars happening in the world. I'd love to hear what your channel has to say about that.
My channel has been warning me about this for a long, long time.
Okay.
It's just that I had no way to bring it out. So I sat on the information for all these years. But I've known about this for a long time. You're going to see changes that are going to turn upside down the things that we know. The oligarchs who are ruling this country right now are going to be out of existence. Something is going to happen. I don't know what it is, because it's technology. And I can't identify technology, but something is going to happen. And the oligarchs who are controlling everything right now will cease to exist, whether they will die off or replaced. I don't know. I do know that they won't be around. The things that will be around aren't here yet. We have no way of knowing what they are because they're not in existence yet. But I see new things coming in. I see people out of work. I see famine coming into this land. I see internal wars that are going to be happening in the not too distant future in this country. And they scared the hell out of me. But I can't turn off the channel. When it wants to tell me something, it just proceeds to tell me. And that's what it's showing me. It's showing me that the things that we're accustomed to seeing, we will not be seeing in the future. And the things that we're saying couldn't possibly happen will happen. I don't think I've ever seen so many changes as I'm seeing flash in front of my eyes, even now.
This is all going to happen within my lifetime.
How long are you going to live?
I don't know. 100, 110?
It might.
It's going to be a bumpy road. But
Yes.
But we'll make it out the other end to a better place.
It depends. It depends on... There's a difference between action and reaction. If you have a reaction, it's going to be very difficult for you. If you're going to take it in stride, you'll be okay. But things are going to happen quickly. All of a sudden you'll see them, and then all of a sudden you won't. One of the things I was going to be teaching you when I wanted to open your channel was thought transference, which I'm teaching the people on my team now. It's thought transference. You think it and you make it happen just by thinking it. So I can see someone in my mind's eye who is suffering on the other side of the world, and I can say, God, heal that person completely. And that person will be healed. And that comes with the higher vibration that's coming in. The higher vibration will be here in the next, probably the next 3 to 5 years. It's trying to get in now, which is why people are feeling so discombobulated now. They used to come to me and say, tell me about my husband, my wife, my children, my finances, my this, my that. They're not coming to me and saying that anymore. Those aren't the questions that they're asking. They want to know about the vibrations that they're feeling. And those who are sensitive enough are feeling the vibrations. I feel them every day because I'm an empath. So I pick up everyone's illnesses, I pick up everyone's vibrations. I don't recognize faces or voices. I recognize vibrations. And that's how I found you.
Did you have anything else from your time in Atlantis and Egypt that you want to tell us about?
Yes. In Egypt, Amenhotep the fourth. I was shown that. Mm-hmm. And I was shown Ra, the sun god. So the religion was kind of very much different than it is today. Today, religion is based on fear. Mm-hmm. I didn't see that there. What I saw there was devotion. Not knowing, but devoted. I didn't see the division that I'm seeing in this country or anywhere else in the world. Mm-hmm. Like Ireland. Mm-hmm. Catholics against Protestants at warfare, killing each other. Ridiculous.
Yeah, but all in the name of Christ.
Huh?
All in the name of Christ.
Yes.
Of course.
Look at all the crusades that were in the
Yeah.
The children's crusade. Mm-hmm. That was all in the name of Christ. And poor Christ, he had nothing to do with it.
Correct.
It was just man's misconceptions. So yes, we have lived before. Yes, we will live in the future. Yes, the lives do run together. When I used to go into the Akashic Records, which incidentally is very difficult to do because you're seeing them all at one time. Mm-hmm. And there are trillions of Akashic Records for each person. Every thought, every action, everything about you is in the Akashic Record for you. So if you say, can you tell me about a past life? I have to think, now which past life does he want to know about?
Well, I didn't mean to interrupt you.
Pardon me?
I didn't mean to interrupt you, but this is something that I've always wanted to ask you, and I've never asked about this to anybody. What do you have any information about any of my past lives?
Of course I do.
I know that the audience would get a kick out of this. So if you have an interesting one, if you have one.
An interesting one. How the hell would I know which one you would think is interesting?
Okay, how about dealer's choice?
How about what?
Dealer's choice. You, whatever you want to say. I'd love to hear about one of my past lives.
Okay. In this lifetime, and probably why I chose you in this lifetime, was because of what you did in a few past lives, all in conceptually. Mm-hmm. You were very much a healer. You were also very, very wise. People came to you with their problems. So you did counseling, although you weren't really a counselor by profession. You also had the ability to build things. Oh, that was another thing I forgot to tell you. In Egypt, we stood around in a circle, and I was in that circle. I felt all the vibrations from all the people in that circle move. Over 1,000 people in that circle, and we circled around where the pyramid was going to be built. And they were not called pyramids in those days. They are now, but they weren't then. But you were a builder, In this lifetime, you have the same abilities. You use them differently, but you have the same abilities. You were also very artistic in a past life. In this life, you bring that with you. How much of it you use or don't use is immaterial. The fact is that whatever you've had, you bring with you into the current life. So let's say that you were an accountant in this lifetime. And in the next lifetime, you may be a movie star and not interested in numbers at all. But you still carry with you all of your accounting information. You're just not utilizing it in that lifetime. So that's what I'm seeing with you. You bring with you many, many traits, many assets from past lives. I don't think that you're using them all. I don't think that you're using even most of them. But one thing that you are using is your ability for mass communication, which is why I brought you here to start with, because you have a very great responsibility in the years ahead, which will be mass communication.
One thing I want to ask you, Connie, and I know this is something that a lot of people in this community that I've put together with Next Level Soul, this next level, the Soul Tribe, the Next Level Soul Tribe, are curious about where this show and the mission that we're trying to do in the world to spread this kind of knowledge and information and experience out to people who have never seen or heard the stories that we talk about on the show, or the knowledge that we bring out, or the gurus, or the love, whatever we're putting out there. Can you tell the audience what you see for this show and where and what impact it's going to have on the planet?
Oh, sure, I can. I knew before you even started.
I know you did.
This show is one of a kind. There can be all kinds of copycats, but nothing will equal this show, especially once it really gets started.
We haven't kicked off yet?
We're in its infancy, darling.
Wow. Okay.
You haven't seen anything yet. Okay. You've only seen what I've allowed you to see. Mm-hmm. No more. Eventually, you're going to have to see the whole thing so that you can distribute it well enough. Now, this show will hit. It has to hit trillions of people. And I was made very aware of how it was going to happen. Mm-hmm. The meditation that I told you about, that was just to protect your physical body. Nothing else. It was so I wouldn't have to worry about you. Mm-hmm. The higher vibrations are powerful. And they are in combat, so to speak, with the lower vibrations that we're on now. Mm-hmm. People will have to be making a choice. And I tell everybody who comes to me, do not make the choice now. I don't want to hear it now. Mm-hmm. I want you to think long and hard before you make a choice. Because once you make that choice, you can't go back and forth. If you choose to go on the higher vibration, you can't go back to the lower vibration or vice versa. So think long and hard before you make a choice. Now, the choices will be this. How to do this delicately?
Please.
I'm supposed to do this delicately?
Please.
All right. I'm thinking. I'm not accustomed to delicate. As you will know. Whatever you have, whatever you've started in this lifetime, whether it's a relationship, a project, a belief system, will be taken away from you and replaced with something better. But because you have not seen what is better, it's like the devil you know as opposed to the devil you don't know. So some people want to stay here, and that's fine. No, you know, it doesn't matter which choice you make, because you're going to be living it. That's why I want you to do it carefully. You think long and hard about the things, because everything will be taken away from you, whether it's your relationships, if they're not as spiritual as you are, will be taken away and will be replaced with something better. Everything has been laid out by God, and your physical, mental, financial, emotional needs will all be taken care of. You'll be able to change your career every 5 minutes if you want. You can start one career. If you don't like it after a few minutes, you can look at another career and go into that on the higher vibration. On this vibration, you can't do that. And so that would be taken away and replaced with something better, which is that you will have more choices. No harm, no foul. And that's coming on the higher vibration that's coming into the planet, into the galaxy. You will have those choices. I was trained on the higher vibration. I was a high priestess in Atlantis, in Egypt, in China, in Asia Minor. So I bring with me all the knowledge and all the training that you could possibly want.
Okay.
And that is what I do in all of my sessions now.
All right. Connie, is there anything else that you would like to say to the audience before we wrap this episode up?
Yes. Everything depends on visualization, on your thought process as well, and on your commitment to helping mankind. If you help mankind, your negative karma dissipates very quickly. It's when you don't help mankind that you seem to accrue all the negative karma that you possibly can. So if you want that to disappear, help mankind to the best of your ability, and it will disappear. I've watched it happen. I've seen it, and I know it exists.
All right. Connie, I want to thank you for sharing your experiences and knowledge with all of us, and for everything you've done for me over the years, and also for everything that you're doing to still help awaken people and help them help awaken the planet. So I appreciate you more than words can say, my dear. So thank you again for everything.
Thank you for having me.